Welcome back to the False Nine Podcast, here with episode 126 with my brother-in-law. That's what you call it, right? George Garcia, owner and worker of Waco Whatabounce, proud sponsor of this video. Anyways, we have my brother-in-law here. We don't even know what we're going to talk about. We don't know what we're going to say, but we're just going to talk. Before we, the other clip, I guess, messed up, we're talking about in the gym, how weights make a difference. Mm-hmm. How are, like, the type of weights. One thing, when I was at Charter, I did a lot more. When I got here to Gold's, I couldn't lift that much weight anymore.
Yeah.
You know? But why is that, bro? Like, I know you used to be more into the gym stuff back in the day.
In high school, I just did everything they did in the field house, varsity.
But why is it that the weights feel heavier and lighter in some different gyms? Or when you go to different places? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, the bumper plates are a lot, they bounce.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know,
They just feel lighter?
Yeah. Mm. But I don't know how accurate the weight is.
So you said you used to do a 300 almost?
I maxed out at like 275, and then after that I got like close to 300, but
never quite there.
I squatted 335.
Yeah,
that's it though.
Yeah,
I never got close again.
I did front squat, got like 385 or something.
Damn, Joey. Okay.
So, I guess, since we don't know what we're going to talk about, really, but I do want to ask you this. I want to, because I don't know too much, like, how you started doing your business, which is obviously, well, I mean, I know now, but it's inflatables, water slides, bounce houses, tables, chairs, things like that. How did, like, that first... like start for you? I know you told me that your parents started it.
They started the whole thing when I was 4 or 5 years old.
Mm-hmm.
So
then
they moved to Waco and then like rented out for like a few weekends.
Mm-hmm.
And then whenever I moved to College Station, came back, I was like, man, I need to make some money. So
you were in College Station, you came back, and you were like, I need to make some money.
Yeah.
And then what? They didn't have many inflatables already.
I only have four.
Four?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
And how much do you have now?
Like 25.
No way, for real?
If you add the mechanical bolt to it, yeah. That's Dang. Another unit.
That's crazy. And when was it when... they had like four bounce houses. How many years ago was that?
Dude, I don't know. They're old.
Do you even have any of those anymore?
I still have them. Like, I'm surprised. The other day I was like talking to my dad and my mom. Like, hey, who made these? Like,
yeah.
They're good. Like, they're good. They're heavy duty. Like,
oh, like they last?
They last. They're not as heavy. They're probably like 100 pounds maybe, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But the material is just...
it's good.
It's been lasting, yeah. Like, I'm thinking this year I've finally seen, like, damage, you know?
On those?
On those.
Oh, shit, man.
Like...
and how many... so, do you still have all of them that you when they first started?
I only have three of the four.
Okay.
One of them was pretty...
beat up?
Yeah.
Damn.
So,
and then how many years ago was this? Like, when you first started like renting them out?
I'm gonna say like 3 or 4 years ago.
3 or 4 years ago.
Yeah. Okay. So, probably had them like 15 years ago.
Damn. Mm-hmm.
So okay. In those, you said 3 years ago, right? So in those 3 years, all of a sudden you have 25 now, right?
Yeah. Well, really. The water slides and stuff didn't start till like last summer.
Right.
I remember when you and my sister first started talking. Not first talking, but I guess you guys were like still kind of, I don't even know where you guys were at. But she was out. Mm-hmm. Well, you guys were at a point where we went out to a town in... Were you guys good?
I'm good.
We went out to a town in Bruceville. Bruceville, Eddie? Or Troy? I don't know. But I helped her. And it was like in the fall. I helped her with a bouncy house.
Yeah.
And I was... probably. I don't know.
I remember. It was a Moody.
And I was just like... She's like, can you help me? And I was just like, I mean, I guess, you know, I don't even know what the fuck's going on, but I don't know what I was doing. I don't think I was really doing much with my life, like, to be honest with you. And that's why I kind of went. And then it was cool and all, but I was just like, I didn't know how, like, serious you were about it or how serious, like, that was. But I was like, okay, that's cool, you know, like, you do inflatables.
Mm.
And I didn't really know you, so, like, I was just like, oh, like, that's cool. I thought it was kind of weird at first, to be honest.
Yeah.
So then, and then also, too, when sometime last year, I remember, I don't know if it was last year. I think it was last year in the beginning, right before the summer, before you got busy. I remember it was a fish light that I had to help my sister with. And then I remember Angel was trying to help us, too, and we couldn't, like, get it. Or it was a tropical. I don't know which one it was. But it was too heavy for me and Angel. And Crystal was already pregnant, I think.
Yeah.
You remember, right?
Yeah.
And that's when I first, like, I kind of was interested in his business, you know? But anyway, like, well, I want to backtrack, too, because I really want to talk about and emphasize, like, how you were so persistent with the business or the process itself that, I mean, you could say that you're about, like, you told me that yesterday or this morning that you're kind of, like, it's going to be the first time ever where you have all your units, like, rented out on this in that weekend, like, you know. But before I ask you about that, like, okay, you got your four units. What makes you want to buy another one? What makes you want to get a fifth or a sixth, you know?
Well, I mean, man. Well, before you do all that, you got to always make sure you have help or if you could even do it.
Because
it could cost you some.
It's like a sacrifice.
You're doing, right? I mean.
Like, what you mean?
It costs, you know, like you don't want to buy that fifth or sixth or tenth unit and not make your money back while you're making profit.
Yeah.
It's just sitting there. You need to make sure that thing's going out.
Mm-hmm.
You make sure you have a
team. So, so you knew it was going to, or what you mean? Are you saying like you knew you had people to do it with you or what?
I knew I could do it.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Like if I could do it by myself, then I could do it.
Yeah. And were you like, were you like, I'm just trying to make some money? Or were you like, what was the motive behind it, really?
The motive was to really to be like the best in Waco, man. Like the biggest.
Like before, like even where you're at now, you were just like, let's see where this goes.
Yeah, I was like, man.
But your intent was that.
My intent was to be like the most known.
Mm-hmm.
In Waco and like make sure that okay like if someone needs something like oh go to this company.
Mm-hmm. See I didn't know that.
Yeah,
so when you first
so it wasn't about the money, it was more like
you want to be that guy that helped that business.
Yeah,
as far as
the business to be like okay
and the thing the about top. Yeah and the thing about well this is how I see it from outside of Texas and everything, bro. The bouncy house is just fucking work out here in Texas, you
it's
know?
Funny. Yeah.
Over there,
dude,
I feel like there's nothing over there.
Whenever you were living out there for so long, like I've seen so many people like selling units out there or blowers or
and
any type of equipment,
mm-hmm.
and like I was like on the edge to like just ask you guys like, hey, if you ever come back, like when you come back, make sure. You can do me a favor, you know, bring me this. Or,
I know my sister mentioned it to me one time.
Really?
Yeah, because, you know, there's, in this business, a lot of people get into, like, I guess the game or the business.
Yeah.
They just don't know how
I feel like they
heavy
know.
Or how much work
mm-hmm.
and time, like, the whole thing. Yeah. And, like, the other day, this person brought, like, four or five. Just because, like, they saw the numbers of people making money.
Mm-hmm.
And then when the time came to actually make that money to work, they quit. They gave up. Wow. Sold all of that.
Damn.
Yeah.
Yeah, but. So you're. So be like even like, you had your 4 or 5 units. You were like, you know what? I'm gonna try and be the best I can be in town. Mm-hmm. And then, when you got your first, when did you realize? I'm pretty sure it was last year in the mm-hmm. summer. Next when you realized summer. Where you were like, oh shit, or maybe it was like, oh damn, like this shit popping off.
Well, so when I was working over at Mahia, this mm-hmm. guy at the fire station said, hey, what you do on your days off? That's kind of a big topic, like,
right.
At the fire department, someone's like, hey, everyone has like a side gig, side mm-hmm. hustle going on. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, well, what I do is inflatables. Mm-hmm. Like, shoot, I work with someone that does inflatables. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, really? So, you know, that's how the conversation starts. Mm-hmm. And then they're like, well, they're trying to close their business. They got some water slides. And I'm like, I already knew water slides make most of the money.
Yeah.
You know. But my parents were like, no.
For real?
Yeah.
Wow.
They thought it was like more of a... what if an accident happens or you know, more like
a hazard?
Yeah. Yeah. Be more reliable to it. But if you like make sure your units are good to go, like they're safe.
Yeah.
You know, meet the requirements, you should be fine.
You even got a contract out
on everything too, right? Yeah.
Well, the waiver. Yeah.
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 So and I was like, man, I'm gonna start it, you know?
Yeah, dude, for sure.
So when you're, that's, I didn't know that either. Like when you were, so that guy told you my hand, you were like, all right, shit, fuck it.
Yeah, I was like, man, hey, we'll sell you 2 or 3, whatever, how many you want. Mm. They're expensive, man. The water units are expensive. Just because, you know, they make you so much money. That's so true. It costs.
And this was, this was like 2019? Do you think this was before, was this?
I'm gonna say 2018, but like I said, like earlier, people just buy units mm-hmm. and they just don't know how much work it is.
Yeah.
Like that 24-foot slide I got, mm-hmm. that's the first one I got.
Yeah.
You know, and I was like, I can't move this 700-pound slide by myself.
Yeah.
Damn.
You know. So.
So this was in 20. When you bought your first water slide, was in 2018.
2018. I was still by myself, like, you know, if my dad couldn't help me, I couldn't do it by myself. Mm-hmm. So
you were renting out in that summer or in 19 summer?
It just depends on the schedule. If I got the help, yeah, I'll rent it out.
Damn.
But
so you were already renting water slides before even, like, I was involved. And mm-hmm. what about Crystal?
Yeah.
Before she was involved too? Before she was in your life? Or, like, talking?
It was, like, at the beginning. She was in the beginning.
Oh, okay.
She helped me out.
I remember that, yeah.
We spent like almost 3 hours one time.
Oh my god. Oh, yeah. That you guys got stuck in like some mud, bro.
Wow.
Yeah.
Because I remember one time me and Angel were kind of like bitching. And then he goes, shit. And both of them were like, shit, y'all should have seen that one day. We got stuck in the mud. Was it raining? Or what, did it rain or something? Or was it muddy?
So it was just, they used so much water. Mm-hmm. In the pool, and it just like overflow, and then it was like the whole weekend.
Yeah.
And then the only place they had was like they had a lot of cattle, mm-hmm. so this was like in the back.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just there was mud, poop right? too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, there was poop. I remember she told me that.
Yeah. So even though I put a tarp down and everything, mm-hmm. it just we showed up. Everything was just full of.
Water and then this was probably black, red, or dark. That's
nice. My god,
I remember, yeah, one time we were rolling up a water slide and we were like kind of complaining, like, oh, this shit's hard. They're like, well, shit, me and Crystal did it, and like mm-hmm. it took us like 3 hours in the mud. And I was like, oh, shit, that sucks,
yeah,
but yeah,
yeah, that was our first rental actually, I think,
for real.
Yeah.
Damn, that's
did
tough.
That scare you almost?
You were like, fuck this,
yeah, did that kind of scare
like
you?
Discourage you, I guess,
yeah.
In a way, yeah, but it was fun because that whole time we thought nobody was home.
Yeah.
Like, man, because I saw tractors. I saw, I'm like, man, we could use this tractor and just push it up there, you know? But nobody was home.
Yeah.
And then we're full of mud and, you know, all this whatever. And, like, old lady comes out with a water hose. Like, hey, let me clean. Yeah, let me rinse you out.
That's funny. What did that make you think of Crystal that day?
Oh, she...
Were you like, she a real one?
Yeah, always.
That's funny.
Yeah,
that's
cool. Dude, that thing, the unit itself is already 700 pounds. Plus the water is almost like double the weight. Yeah, the water weighs like 8 pounds. So.
Yeah. Because, yeah, she did help out a lot. And then once she got pregnant, it's where she was like just doing the best she could.
Yeah. She was doing a lot of the
paperwork, talking to people. Yeah, I remember that. Last summer was like, it was crazy, but I don't want to talk about it just yet. So, do you remember what happened 2019, like in the winter, like in the fall, right before basically last year, the summer got started, like in the cold? Do you remember how was the business going, or was it just pretty dead? Because I think that's when I helped you, I think. And Crystal, it was like that 2019 in the fall, or if it was either like January of 2020.
It was still going, but
I think it was January 20.
I didn't really put that much attention to it. Mm-hmm. I was kind of like, let me see if I could do it, you know? Mm-hmm. Or even if I felt like doing it, like, let me see what's going on that weekend, you know? But people were calling, but sometimes I'll be like, hey, Chris, I don't want to do this, you know?
Yeah.
I had some pretty bad habits as well, so.
Yeah, man, for sure.
Were you going to ask something?
I was going to just be like, those habits changed now, right?
Like, yeah.
I'm working under you now. It's just like, it's kind of crazy to see the difference in a way, you know, more.
Oh, yeah.
You should have. Just last year itself was pretty interesting.
Yeah.
And now that I kind of, you mean, it was basically, I don't want to say like the same, but it was like slowly picking up. And then last year, it seems like it just kind of like, poof, it just took off.
It did.
It was crazy, bro. Yeah. Because like I said, I helped you and I was like, what? Like, I wasn't like kind of like judging what you were doing, but I was just like, I don't know. I wasn't very supportive of like your business, I guess you could say. And I don't mean that in a mean way at all. I was just like, oh, like, you know, I thought it was just weird doing your own thing. And this was before I even wanted to have my own business too, though. You know, my mindset was somewhere else. I was like, oh, that's weird. Like, you're really trying to make some money. I don't know. I just thought it was weird.
Yeah.
You know, and it wasn't like nothing negative. I just thought it was like weird. And where I was at, like, I didn't think like about business and making your own thing or nothing like that. So then like me kind of also changed it and also seeing like, because when your stuff started kind of picking up, it's when I started, like, you know, and I think I would talk to you a lot about this, but it's when I started wanting to, like, oh, I want to do my own business. I want to do that. I want to do this. So that's when I started to change, too. And I was like, oh, well, let me help George with this. And then it kind of was just, oh, shoot, I need you to help me on the weekends. You know? And then I wasn't working. Like, I wasn't working at all. So yeah. I don't know when. Do you remember what weekend was it when we were like, damn. I don't remember. I feel like I had to be in April, though.
It
just, like, out of nowhere.
It'd be like that, bro. Some weekends, man.
It'd be like that a lot, yeah. Right? Like, just damn.
Well, for sure, last year. Last season was like,
dude, last. It's crazy. I was only with you guys for like a month. 2 months, I think. Because I left like in the midsummer.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure you still had a lot
more. Oh, yeah.
But it was crazy because we would work from like 7-8 in the morning all the way to like 12 midnight, bro. And we would have a break from like 3 to 5. We would go bushes. We went to Eskimo hunt. We were like burn, bro. I still probably got my tan line from right here, bro.
Yeah.
Like, it was crazy. Like, and it was so many days that we were like, man, this shit sucks. Yeah. We don't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. I was sweating, like straight sweating, bro. What is it called? Like, chafing? Rosado?
Yeah.
Like, you're rosado, bro. For real. And then, like, little Angel, like, having, like, I don't want to say he, oh, man. I don't want to say he, well, he was a lot more lazier. Yeah. And then, like, his mindset of work. We had so many conversations about Angel, bro, me and him.
That's my manager now, though. Yeah.
And then, like, Crystal had to talk to him. And, like, oh my God. I don't think both of us ever thought that he was still going to be in the picture. Yeah. You know, if I'm being mess around with that,
I'm like, man, late. Like, how far are you right now? Yeah. Don't call
me. Like, and it's so funny because, like, I didn't, I guess everything I missed out too, like, after I left, like, when after I left, like, you know, and I went to Illinois. Mm-hmm. I mean, for me, I didn't think about, like, the growth in the business and in Angel. Mm-hmm. So now when I came back and I see him on that shit, I was like, oh, Angel's a little bit better now.
He's going at it, yeah.
But, dude, I remember, I don't know when was the first time, but I remember when I was said, bro, this shit sucks. Yeah. Oh, I do remember the first time.
Yeah.
I sure do. Krista asked me, she's like, hey, can you help George just pick up on, and I think we went somewhere pretty far, and we were with your dad. And I was like, and I was wearing socks, and I was wearing shoes. And then my shit got wet right away. And I was like, what the fuck is this, bro? I was upset, bro. I was like, I guess my feet are going to be wet, you know? Yeah. And then,
yeah.
And then I was like, okay, we're just going to do like this one, maybe another one.
Yeah.
And then it was like six or seven, something like that. And I was like, damn, this shit fucking sucks.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But then I was also like, Angel was like, yeah, bro, you gonna get wet. Like, he was like trying to be like all like, you know, like how he is. Like he knew it all. Like, yeah, bro, it'll be hard, bro. Like, you know, like, you know, I got this, you know. But I was like, this is
pretty. He's gone a long way.
Yeah.
I remember he used to, at first he was like, gonna pick up the tarps. Like, but yeah, it's mud on it. I'm like.
Yeah, then he would always do this.
Yeah, he was all the
time. He like, probably still does. I don't know.
No,
he don't.
Nah, he does it by himself now. He like rolls it up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, like he would look at something, he'd just be like, "Yeah." Like, he did not want to get dirty at all.
Oh my God!
Yeah, that's bro. So funny. And I would get on to him so many times too. It was funny.
Yeah.
But
yeah, you did help a lot on that part. And Joe was just.
And then, like, since I seen, like, I started noticing, like, he was kind of serious about it, too. And I was like, well, shit, let's just see where it goes. Like, let me help him the best way I can and just see what happens. And then, like, I started to, like, help you with the posting and all that. And then it slowly just started, like, it's like domino effect. Boom, boom, boom. Then I remember when we did the giveaway, that shit just, like, said, dang. It just went all the way up, bro.
Oh, yeah. It
was crazy. And after that, I mean, every weekend was 10 to fucking all of them, you know?
Yeah.
I remember one time, I think one of the few times when I was there, where we had everything loaded on two trucks. We had like one inflatable, and it was just a bounce house. It wasn't a water slide. Well, I was like, damn, we really got all these out, you know? Yeah. And we had, I think you had like 14, 15 already by then, you know? And I was like, that's crazy. You know, like, we got to pick all these hoes up by tonight. I was thinking about that.
Yeah.
Know? I was like, this is going to suck. But also, it was like a very, like, it was a cool moment, you know?
Yeah.
You know, to think and to see, like, the trailers loaded as fuck and we're just ready to rope.
Yeah.
It was crazy, bro. And then,
You see all that weight. You see all that.
Yeah, bro.
Like, man, that truck could hold. You know? You're like, dang.
I remember. You know? Yeah, bro. I remember one of the first few times where we had to pick up like a lot. We were with your dad. I think it was the same. No, it was another time we were with your dad, and he was just like, "No, just stack it up there." And like the trailer was like so stacked. And since we didn't know what it was like to have a full trailer, that shit was just so stacked, bro. It was so ugly,
like a mountain.
Yeah, bro.
My God.
And he had the dolly, and he just had the straps. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure now you're more organized with it, but
oh yeah,
no, definitely.
But it was funny because it was just such like. I guess an experience at first.
Yeah.
And then, like, everybody, like, put so much effort and time, you know, like, not just George. He probably put the most, not everybody, though, because, I mean, it was his stuff.
Yeah.
Then, like, I did the best I could. And I'm surprised how much I helped you. And I don't mean that, like, in a long way, because I don't like to, like, really work like that. if I'm being honest.
Yeah.
And then also Angel, how much like he was like willing to like, fuck, I guess I'll suck it up today. And then, but I think he started to realize that he was making some money, and then that kind of like, I think that that
motivated him for sure.
And yeah, it did motivate him. And then just like constantly every weekend, it was like, okay, every Saturday and Sunday we're doing this, every Saturday and Sunday we're doing this.
Yeah.
And then now you look back and you're like, damn, I don't know, I've been thinking about that a lot lately. I'm just like, how the conversations that we have now versus the ones we had last year were so different. Like, we were just like, it was more like just work, 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 work. And now it's more like organizing and work, organizing and work, organizing and work.
No, yeah, for sure. It's definitely.
Yeah.
And it's just so cool to see something like that. And then, like, the conversations are just so different.
Yeah. And I mean, I feel like coming into, like, I guess, like, coming in now to where George is now with the company and stuff for his job. It's a lot more organized, you know? I mean, I help him out and everything. And, yeah, I mean, everything runs smooth. Everything's good, you know? We have no complaints. But I think it's so funny just seeing, I guess, how you guys are, like, saying about Angel, how he was back then. Yeah. You know, even he's changed and he's become more organized. And he's more, like, manager material, you could say. It's hilarious, bro. But, yeah, I mean. From what I've heard, it's just like, dude, I could tell you guys have gone like a long way with it.
It has been, because, dude, it would suck so bad, bro, to like to the point where it was just like, fuck, this shit sucks.
Oh, definitely.
You know, and
yeah,
it was just like that every weekend. Mm-hmm. I remember one time too, bro, I got ate up by mosquitoes. Yeah. That pissed me off. And I was like, man, this, like, why are we doing this?
Yeah.
Spiders, just little, like, insects. It could be anything, bro. Like, it was just annoying. Dogs.